I'm in the Vatican. Buongiorno. I know what you're thinking. I'm standing in front of a green screen at a studio in Burbank, California, and they've digitalized the Vatican in behind me. No, no. That's really the Vatican. I ought to know. I just got thrown out of it. See, I wanted to interview the Pope, but I was willing to settle for a cardinal or a Monsignor or the Flying Nun, really anybody, but apparently I've been on the Catholic shit list for quite a while. But that's their loss, because now I'm going to say what I really think, which is mainly, does that look anything like anything Jesus Christ had in mind?
When you look at a building like that, a giant palace, does it seem at odds with the message of the founder?
Well, certainly.
Well, thank you. Obvious.
It really is obvious, isn't it?
I mean,
but does it bother you?
Well, I mean, yes, it does.
Yeah, but
I mean, I wouldn't, if I were the boss, I wouldn't be living there. I mean, Jesus would be probably out in some barracks here in a suburb of Rome, got it?
And you ever get so fed up you want to take the collar off and go?
No, I don't wear a collar
anyway. That's it, Captain. Take my badge and my collar.
No, I read about 10 books recently, the rationality of religion, and everyone's saying it's stupid. Ba-ba-bee-ba-boo-ba.
You know what's going to happen to them.
No,
they're going to be roasting in hell.
Come on, roasting. That's the old Catholic thing.
That's what they taught me.
Yeah, I know. Had hell business.
Well, come on. The standard doctrine that I was taught as a kid.
Yeah, that's all gone. That's all finished.
But that's not fair.
Yeah.
The date of Jesus' birth really wasn't established until 349 A.D.
Oh, yeah. That's just, because he might have been born on July 3rd. These are all nice stories, you know.
And that doesn't bother you either?
Well, that bothers me, too. I mean, when everyone's like, ooh, we have to have midnight mass because Jesus was born on midnight on 25th.
Yeah.
This is all nonsense.
You're a maverick, aren't you?
I'm not a maverick,
you know.
You're
Father Maverick. You do things your own way. Walking tall and proud in hell town. When you add up all the saints and all the angels and archangels and super-duper angels, and there's God, the Father, God the Son, the Holy Ghost, Mother Mary. It does start to look like it's not quite the monotheistic religion that it's
I understand. Like we have many gods.
Yeah, well, it does seem like that. I mean, if people pray to...
Well, but some people just don't understand this. You probably are. You don't follow things. But they had a survey here in Italy, you know, and they said, you know, in a crisis to who, what kind of saints do you pray to? Got it? You know who's the sixth on the list? Jesus Christ.
The sixth.
He's the sixth man that the Italians call upon when they have problems. Isn't that neat?
That's
talk about cafeteria Catholics. What?
So how do you convince people of what's the true
faith? Don't forget it. You just have to live and die with their stupid ideas. I'm sorry. What are you gonna do?
You can go to a pitch meeting.